That's what you said about the
Yeah. All right. Yeah, right, guys and girls, welcome back to another video of mine on my YouTube channel. Now, I hope you can hear me. What about now? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me whispering in the microphone? Okay, so hopefully it's nice and clear. Right, so today I want to get two videos done. Or technically, hopefully two videos on this camera I'm using, the Panasonic 4K camcorder. Hopefully it's nice and clear as well. So basically we're looking at Xbox today, and also I'm going to be looking through some of these 4K limited edition Batman movies that we got here, with the Christian Bale films, the Christopher Nolan collection of the Batman Begins, the Batman Dark Knight, and the Dark Knight Rises. We're gonna have a look at that 4K Ultra HD HDR movies, high dynamic range for brighter, deeper, more lifelike colors. Now I might have to do two separate videos because I might run out of battery by the time I've done this. So we're going to look on the Xbox store at the moment, because, and what's this? Minecraft Dungeons, Unite, Fight and Survive. So they've got a new game coming out, whenever that is, or is it already out? So different games on the Xbox. I do different games, well, I do Xbox games, PlayStation games, talks on PC games, VR, Oculus, you name it. Alright, so basically, this is already out by the looks of it, and it's free with the the Game Pass, Xbox Live Game Pass. I've just actually cancelled my subscription. It finishes in September, so to be honest, it's plenty of time, so I've cancelled it now. That way, it doesn't add on to my next bill and my next one. So what's this one about? Minecraft. Fight your way through all an all-new action-adventure game inspired by classic dungeons, crawlers, and set in the Minecraft universe. Up to four friends can play together, or you can brave the dungeons alone. Includes a hero cape, two player skins, and a chicken pet. It also includes two DLC packs, and when they become available, and that is actually looks like it's available now. When was this one out? When did this come out? This was released on the release date 26th of the 5th. So actually, hang on, so we're still on the 4th, so this ain't out yet then technically. I suppose you can just preload it then, basically. Is it available on Tuesday, May the 26th, 2020, 9 o'clock GMT, time 12 midnight, coordinated universe time. So that will be available on the 26th. I'll probably check it out. I haven't got anything else better to do, so I'll be checking out different games and stuff for you guys and girls. What's this? In-game events. We've got in-game events right now. Fortnite. What's that? Fortnite? What's that? Oh, they've got new skins, new characters. Chapter 2, Season 2 has arrived, and you've been you have been activated. Play as a spy and join the forces of Ghost or Shadow to secure intel, sabotage rival agents, and take back the island of agents is calling. Will you join the fight? Now, I haven't played Fortnite for a while because I'm playing the Call of Duty Warzone at the moment, which is actually fantastic, and I love it, actually, guys and girls. And you can check it out on the stream here or on the actual videos. They've also, with your Xbox Game Pass, most popular right now is Grand Theft Auto 5. Got Minecraft, NBA 2K20, Rocket League is quite popular right now, Total Reliable Delivery Services, Mortal Kombat X, Human Fall Flat, Sea of Thieves. Sea of Thieves is the best looking physics of water I've ever seen in a video game ever, and I mean it. It's something brilliant what they've done with the physics and what it looks so realistic, it looks so real and stuff, so it's absolutely amazing. Halo, the Master Chief Collection. On the PC, I think they've only got a couple, two games, because they're supposed to be updating it over time or something. Because the only game I've been able to actually get is the first game, which is just Halo. I think it's Halo Evolved or something, Combat Evolved. What else we got? We got Gears of War 5, Operation 3. I own that already. Just haven't installed it onto my hard drive. I've just deleted my Xbox One hard drive for the Xbox One X, which was 8 terabytes. Because I'm using that on the PC anyway, so I don't really play on the Xbox that much. But I'm just going to keep you guys and girls up to date on most of the stuff. Ark Survival Evolved, that's quite a good game. It's a survival based game where you're stuck on an island and you've got to basically survive. That's your main objective, survive. Dinosaurs, everything. You've got to build huts, everything. Right, Ace Combat 7 is Sky is Unknown, now on the playlist, on the game pass. That's pretty cool. Dead by Daylight Special Edition includes with Game Pass. We've got Doom, which is the 2016, I think it is, 2016 version. I think it was 2016. Let me just actually correct myself. Let's have a look. When was this one released? Oh, they got a Doom 3 remastered as well on the Xbox. And Doom 64 for $3.99, guys and girls. The 64 version. Jesus. Right, Doom, which is actually 61.21 gigabytes in size. That's probably not included with the updates and all the software and the stuff you get with it. Yeah, 2016 by Bethesda Softworks. And ZeniMax Media Company. So yeah, they've pretty much done that one already. We've got Jump Force. I've actually installed it, but I haven't played it. State of Decay, Juggernaut Edition. State of Decay, absolutely amazing game. It's a survival zombie apocalypse style game where it's open world and you've got to try and basically help all these other ones. Bit like Walking Dead in a way, but alright, actually I need a drink a minute. Alright, The Witcher. Oh, actually, yeah, Pepsi Max, guys and girls. Pepsi Max Ginger. Alright, Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. I don't think that includes the DLC versions. Then we've got Fallout 4, PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds, we've got Batman Arkham Knight, Secret Neighbor, Hello Neighbor, so the two are both on the Game Pass, where you've got to basically find out what the next door neighbor's doing by breaking into his house, because they think he's up to something, maybe doing something CDS and all that. Sniper Elite 4. That's on the Game Pass already. Subnautica Game Pass. I've already got that anyway. I bought that on day one. Journey to the Savage Planet. Not played that, but that's on Game Pass and that's quite popular. Kingdom Hearts 3. Played a little bit of it. Absolutely fantastic. Descenders. that's like a mountain bike style game. Rush, a Disney Pixar. Goat Simulator, Untitled Goose Game. Formula One 2018, Overcooked 2. Fireman Simulator 2017. The Hunter, Call of the Wild. Terraria, Cluster Truck. The Outer Worlds, Super Hot. Yes, is in 2D as well. You got the 3D version, which is like the virtual reality version. Oh, lovely. Nice bit of ginger. Monster Hunter Worlds. The Ninja or Ninjago movie video game. Already on there. 2 Point Hospital. Now, that's in the Game Pass. And that is kind of like the old PlayStation 1 version of Theme Hospital. And that was a classic game back in its day. I used to play a lot of that. Sort of like we used to build your own hospitals and try and get all the medical stuff going on, like with the characters with bloated heads and all that. Just absolutely amazing. My friend Pedro is on Game Pass. Looks like a banana, sort of blood, bullets and bananas. Dirt Rally 2.0. Holy crap, I've just bought that, the whole lot, from Codemasters on Steam. And I can't remember what that was, but I got that really dead cheap and dirt cheap. Actually, I'd say dirt cheap, because it's called dirt. So, yeah, definitely. The Elder Scrolls Online, Tamriel. I actually got the whole PC version of that, the whole box set, the massive limited edition crate, and it comes with like the statue and all that. I got that on my shelf up there. I need to test that all off at some point. Mud Runner. Then we got Dirt 4, Jackbox Party Pack 3, Train Simulator World Game Pass, absolutely free on Game Pass now. Should definitely download it. I've been playing a hell of a lot of it on the PC, not PlayStation, I was going to say PlayStation, but on the PC. And also I've been playing a little bit of the Xbox One version, absolutely very mint indeed. What else games we've got at the moment out, coming out soon? Well, we've got Call of Duty Modern Warfare Campaign Remastered coming out on the 30th. And, oh my god, I'm just looking at the trailer now. It looks amazing, guys and girls. Looks amazing. The guns, the graphics, the content, I mean, the whole content of it. Looks amazing, and they brought back the whole campaign on it, so it just looks like whole. It's remastered. It's like absolutely in 4K. I think they said 4K on the PC. Not too sure how it's going to run on the Xbox One X, but we'll soon find out. Yeah, I do want to actually get a podcast together at some point, because yeah, me and my friend. Mr. 4K Upscaler does a lot of his videos on that. I said to him, yeah, we should like do a podcast at some point. It'd be quite interesting for you guys and girls as well. We could do like live talks, stuff goes on. And then, yeah, just what's going on in the world right now and all that. That's what I want to get to do. We'd do like sort of a journalism style podcast. Maybe talks on freedom of speech as well, because to be honest, we need that freedom of speech right now, rather than getting it killed off. Right, yeah, so Modern Warfare Campaign, remaster pre-order now. I think it's coming out on the 30th, it says. Available on Thursday, 30th of April, 2020. It says it's the campaign. But I'm wondering, maybe they will bring out maybe a campaign, non-campaign, the multiplayer soon afterwards. Or maybe, I would love to see that. Right. So, yeah, we've got some good games. Let's have a look. Release games coming soon. Actually, if I go to the top, and then go to... Actually, let's have a look at deals. Because actually today... What day is it today? It's the 18th, I believe. Right, so it's 9:14 right now. 9:14 at night time. And it's Saturday, 18th of April at the time of this video. And, oh my god, my mouth's full. Right, so... What's that? Couch co-op sales. So what we've got on sale at the moment for the 18th. Right, we have Gears of War 5. Not too sure how much that is because I've already got it. The Handsome Borderlands, the Handsome Collection for £11.24 already, guys and girls, from £44.99. That is you're saving £33 basically. And 75p, that's what it says here. Rayman is on sale. You're saving £18 on that game on Rayman Legends. Castle Crashers, £2.39. Street Fighter, 30th anniversary. Oh my god, what'd you get with it? Let's have a look. Complete the Street Fighter Legacy. So you're getting 12 Street Fighter titles. Celebrate Street Fighter's historic legacy with the Street Fighter 30th Anniversary Collection in this massive collection of 12 Street Fighter titles. Perfect arcade balance makes it to console for the first time ever. Four groundbreaking titles lets you hop online and relive the arcade experience through the online arcade mode or play with friends. Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting, Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, Street Fighter Alpha 3, Street Fighter 3, Third Strike. So I've not played the Third Strike, so... And at £17.49, it's dirt cheap. Considering you're getting the whole collection. Well, not I wouldn't say a whole collection, you're getting more... It's probably the like Street Fighter Hyper games. Dragon Ball Fighter Z at £12.49, normally around £50, so it'd be like $60 in America, roughly, because most games in America is like $60 or something. Portal Knights £5.59. We've also got. The Explorers Edition includes game plus season pass of Ark Survival Evolved for £26.24. And then we've got Bomb Slinger, looks like a cowboy style game. Borderlands 3 on its own, £29.99, so £29.99, £30. We've got Child of Light, £2.99 from £12. You're saving £9, it says here. Contra Rogue Corpse, £15.99, so £16 was £40. I'm wondering if they've got any Resident Evil games, because it looks like there's a lot of Capcom games here. We got any Resident Evil games? Oh, and on the Man from Medan for £12.49. Definitely worth buying, guys and girls. Played the PS4 version. It's a horror-style game where you can determine the outcome of the characters, where you want them to live or die or whatever to say to the other characters. Or it's pretty cool. Love the games, those sort of style games. Then we've got Trials Rising, £12 for the Gold Edition. We've got any Resident Evil? I'm just wondering if there's any. No. So we've got Tom Clancy Splinter Cell. Tom Clancy. Ooh, we've got the Tom Clancy Collection. Blacklist, Splinter Cell, the 360, and the original Splinter Cell game. So how much is that on sale at the moment then? Because I'm pretty sure I've got that one already. We got that one already? Because I think that's in 4K, I think. Yeah, I think it's like, not upscaled, but it's sort of upscaled to 4K from its original resolution, which is, I think is like, was it 480, 500, 560 pixels? Oh, £6, that's not bad. That's pretty bargain for Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Yeah, so they sent the original one. This is just the... Then we've got Conviction for the 360. And how much is that one? That is £7.49, so just under £8. So that's not bad for Conviction. That's a good game, actually. I think I've got that on my 360 collection. The thing is, what they've done with the Xbox One X and all that is they've got rid of the DVR on it, the digital video recorder for 4K, where you can record in 4K, but at high 1 hour long capture on it. So you can't do that no more for some reason, unless they've updated it and fixed it. But I'm going to have a look through it and see what they've done and what they haven't done through the whole system. Cap Ultimate Marvel versus Capcom. That's at £8. That's for three. What else is on sale at the moment? Movies got 35% off. Try Not to Laugh, Hilarious Hits up to 35% off. Grand Theft Auto is £12.49. Just under £13 for the premium edition. The Boss Baby movie by DreamWorks, £4.99. Really good film. Truck Racing Championship, £20 with gold. So if you've got gold, it's £20. Otherwise, you have to pay £40. Formula One 2017. That's at £25. Still a little bit steep, to be honest, for an old game. In my honest opinion about it. And yeah, it's pretty much all the stuff on here at the moment. What's the games coming out? The latest games. Freak Out. Calamity TV Show. It's not really much like exclusives on the Xbox, to be honest. Nothing that's really... like encouraging me to keep playing on the Xbox, to be honest, at all. What's that? World of Warships Legends for free. Aurora. What's that? For free. So what do you get with the free version then? It's a riddle wrapped in a mystery. Aurora Borealis. So what do you get with that then? Includes Tier 2 Cruiser Aurora, 3 days of premium account, 25 times type camouflages, 25 times rare boosters of every type, and 125 in total. 37,000 Commander XP. I might have to do a review on that, because I wanted to play Battleships, World of Warships. I think it's a wargaming.net. So, that should be interesting. No Drifter. Construction Simulator Console Edition for £12.49. World of Simulators. World of Simulators. What's this then? Because I bring in a lot of simulators to the Xbox, which I'm kind of... Firefighters, the simulation you and your team will experience the exciting work of a professional fire brigade service, or surviving realistic missions where you extinguish house fires, salvage Survivalistic missions where you extinguish house fires, salvage, neutralize, and extremely toxic and hazardous substances, accomplish many other fascinating tasks. Fire can be a friend, but also a merciless foe. Nowhere else is the danger greater than at a modern airport with thousands of travelers and highly flammable kerosene. Professional farmer, 2017. Enjoy the life of a farmer with all its amazing tasks. And so that's the bundles. So you get bundles of them. What's this construction simulator though? That's the one I'm thinking. Console edition. Someone that returns to Europe. Discover an idyllic. Idyllic European town. With officially licensed vehicles by famous brands, Caterpillar, Bobcat, Palfinger, Steel, a lot of other ones on there. Explore a 10-kilometer map, lovingly designed to resemble the idyllic Alpine foothills, and play in three different districts: the village where you establish your company, a spacious industrial area, and a modern town. Use the time between jobs to explore the freely drivable open world. A lot of these are coming to console now, guys and girls, as well, so it's pretty cool. What's this? Resident Evil 3 Raccoon City Edition. I've already got, Resident Evil 3 for 50 quid, though. I mean, obviously, you're going to pay 50 quid to play Resident Evil 3, which is, supposed to be a good game, but, I've heard the original game's a lot better on the Nemesis, and actually, I played the demo on it. Oh my god, that is a really, really tough nut to crack. That Nemesis. Like, you'll just move somewhere, and then he'll just find you, and then he'll just be right in front of you, and he tries to come under the door. It's why, if you shut the door, he opens up the door, and then just comes right through, and then lets himself in. I mean, the cheek he get. He didn't even knock on the door. What's this? Doom 64. Legends. I mean, if you guys and girls want me to do a Xbox One X review or live stream of the new Resident Evil 3, let us know in the comments below. But it's like me wanting to basically afford 50 quid just to play that shitty game. Let's have a look. Let us know what you think of the microphone as well, because I've got the microphone here. Hopefully it's not too loud. If it is too loud, let us know in the comments below. I'm plugging it in using my camcorder, and then I've got this basically logged in here, so you can actually hear me talking like this up close. I've got it right towards my face. I don't know whether I should need to be really close like I am now, or maybe step back a little bit like this. Just Cause 4 Gold Edition. Bloody hell, 50 quid. Tomb Raider Definitive Edition. I mean, I picked that up really cheap the other day on Google Stadia. And I'll tell you what, it's probably a hell of a lot better on the Google Stadia than it is the Xbox One X. But anyway, guys and girls, I'm going to finish this episode off because my battery's about to die on me. But if you enjoyed the episode, do leave a like, favourite, share, comment, subscribe. I will be doing, I've got to change the battery over for a minute. And once I've changed the battery over, I'm going to be doing my video reviews on the quality of Batman Begins, and show you what's inside it, what the disc looks like, and all that kind of goodiness. But anyway, cheers for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you on the next episode. See you soon.